In this tutorial, you'll learn how to create this clean, professional, modern and intuitive animated timeline effect in Microsoft PowerPoint using the morph transition and some graphic design principles. So let's get started. Begin by opening your PowerPoint application and then create a new blank presentation. The first slide will serve as the title slide. I'll go ahead and add this text and graphics on the slide. Apple's recent launch of its carbon neutral campaign has inspired this tutorial, which covers all the campaign's key objectives. It's important to note that this video is not sponsored by Apple, although that would have been fantastic. The materials presented here are intended solely for educational purposes. If you would like to replicate the same title, simply navigate to Draw tab and choose the black pen option. Then click and drag to create the numbers and circle. Now let's insert the icons I have carefully selected for this tutorial. If you have access to an icon bundle, feel free to use it. However, PowerPoint's built-in icons will work perfectly as well. We'll arrange these icons in a horizontal layout at the bottom of the slide. Before we continue, I'll quickly change the theme of my PowerPoint so we can see the icons. With that out of the way, let's proceed and add rectangles and text for each icon. Once that step is completed, I'll select the line tool, hold down the shift key, and draw a horizontal line spanning the slide. Let's increase its weight to approximately 6 points and apply a black color. Next, let's group all the icons and position them along the line. I'll send the line to back and move them just below the slide canvas. Now let's take it up a notch. Let's start by selecting the first icon, including its shape, and rotate it approximately 45 degrees. Then, select only the icon, open graphics format, and increase its transparency to 98%. And for the text, right-click on it, select format shape, and navigate to text options. Scroll down to transparency and set it to 98%. Our goal is to first present these icons and text elements with a partial visibility and gradually reveal them as they take the center stage. I'll repeat these actions for the remaining icons, and to speed up the process, I'll now skip to the final icon. Now let's grab the icons, text and horizontal line and shift them to the right side of the slide. I'm going to enable guides to ensure the line is in the middle of the slide. Let's bring the starting point of the line behind the first icon. Moving forward, we are going to duplicate this slide, but before that, let's label the shapes so that Morph Transition will know which shape to morph into. And since this information is not intended for our audience, I'll give the label the same font color as the shapes. Now let's proceed over to slide 1 and duplicate it. On the duplicated slide, let's begin by reducing the size of the year 2030 and text Apple. With the adjustment sorted, I will zoom out and select all the icons and the line. Then I'll shift them into the slide until the first icon is positioned at its center. To make room for the first icon, I'll slightly move the others backward. Now it's time to reveal the text by resetting its transparency back to 0%. Additionally, let's increase its size from 12 to 18 points. Let's also reveal the icons and revert their rotation. Select the square, click on the yellow dot, and drag to convert the square into a circle. Following this, choose both the icon and the circle. Expand their size and position them in the center. Don't worry, the full impact of these transformations will come to life when we apply the morph transition. And speaking of morph, let's head over to Transitions tab and click on Morph to get a preview. Before we proceed, let's revert the transition and advance to the next icon. To begin, duplicate slide 2. Now on slide 3, our first step is to reduce the size of the icon and text. Then shift them along with the line to the left side of the slide. Naturally, we'll need to extend the line on the opposite side and move the icons forward until the second icon is at the center. We'll now create space for the second icon by shifting the remaining icons away from the slide. And just as we did with the first icon, let's reveal this one as well, starting with the text below it. Set transparency back to 0 and increase its size to 18 points. As for the icon, we'll flip its transparency and rotation back to the original settings. Then reshape it into a circle. Expand its dimension and position it in the center. Let's see how this plays out. I'll go to Transitions tab and click on Morph. That is sleek and beautiful. From this point forward, the drill is the same for the rest of the icons. First, duplicate the slide. Reduce the size of the previous icon and move it to the left. Then move the next icon to the center. Make room for it. Review both the text and icon. Rotate the icon back to its initial position and increase its size. And that's all you have to do. Now let's jump to the final part of this video. We have a total of 15 slides. One slide each for one icon. In conclusion, let's insert an image of a cityscape in the center of every slide, positioned behind the icons. This presentation revolves around Apple's aggressive efforts to combat climate change, and is worth noting that a significant portion of greenhouse pollution emanates from urban areas, hence this image. And finally, I'll skip the first slide and select the rest. Go over to Transitions tab and click on Morph. Then move to the right and set duration to 1 second. Let's see the result in slideshow. Ladies and gentlemen, by 2030, Apple plans to have zero carbon footprint, reduce transportation emission by 95%, use 100% clean electricity in all Apple offices, stores and data centers, plant forests in South America, restore grasslands in Africa, and mangroves in Colombia, eliminate plastic from its packaging by 2024, phase out leather in iPhone cases, use 100% recycled aluminium enclosures on MacBooks, Apple TVs, and Apple Watches, carbon neutral Apple offices, commitment from more than 300 Apple suppliers to 100% clean renewable electricity, protect earth, soil, plants, and trees, continue to reduce water usage, already at 63 billion gallons. The big question is, will Apple be able to meet these targets by 2030? What do you think? Hey, you've made it to the end of this video. I have a lot more that you're going to find interesting. Just click to watch the next one and make sure to subscribe to always know when I post new videos.